set here at Beckett's Gate for the running of the Detonator Stakes. Starter hit the button, went bang in the detonator, and they're racing. And Utgard Loki, the first of them to spring the stalls over Cockney Crew out well. Friaresque is being bustled forward. So is the Big Show rolling up there, coming over Trap for Fools. Very wide though through the first 250, going up there with Wrinkly around the outside. Harry Thomas ahead of Friaresque. A bit more than a length, Montalina, Touch of Silver down on the inside then as they work over towards the back straight. Divine Shadow, followed further back by Last of the Line, Paddy Shadow and Upward Others. Further back, He's a Parker Rather, and then Superior Smile, and tailing off behind them about four lengths behind the field, the mare She's a Light. They go out onto the Swan River side at the 1100, and taking up the running first up, Cockney Crew led Trap for Fools, who was able to whip over their trapper. A length away on the inside is Wrinkly, followed then by the Big Show up running fourth. Utgard Loki fifth on the rail. Three quarters of a length away, Harry Thomas moving around them three deep at the 800, followed in turn by the mare Montalina. Back behind those, Friaresque is in the middle. Divine Shadow is over on the inside, getting shunted back there with Last of the Line and Touch of Silver. He's a Parker. Superior Smile, and then Paddy Shadow, and tacking on, She's a Light, as they headed by the 550 in the detonator. It's Cockney Crew just in front as Trap for Fools goes up now to giving the big eyeball. Trap for Fools on the outside of Cockney Crew. Wrinkly getting strung up. Montalina's about to move to the outside of Harry Thomas. The Big Show back inside of those, and Last of the Line has come right around the field, dashed up quickly. Last of the Line at the 200 hit the front. Parnham goes for the stick on Modelina, trying to match it with Last of the Line, but Last of the Line beats off Modelina. It's Last of the Line pulling clear. Fabulous performance to win the detonator. Last of the Line beat Modelina four lengths. Paddy Shadow from Superior Smile, Utgard Loki, then Touch of Silver, Friaresque, Trap for Fools knocking up at the top of the straight. They were followed then by the Big Show. In behind them was Divine Shadow, She's a Light. He's a Parker beat a few home. Harry Thomas, Wrinkly back there as well. And Cockney Crew, who desperately needed that hit out, had knocked right up to finish last. Fabulous win here by Last of the Line, Ryan Hill. What a performance. Picks up his first black type victory by winning this listed detonator stakes. Had to go back and circle them. And the Blackfriars four-year-old has been more than equal to the occasion. He and Montalina coming together at the 250, and Last of the Line putting the Rubik mare away, and they finished paddles in front of the others. 15, Paddy Shadow grabbing third from number 10, Superior Smile. Utgard Loki was fifth home. It was three quarters by four and a quarter. And the time for the race, 1:47.83. Only a second outside the historically run 1980 1800, won by Golden Heights of 1:46.80. They've really run the clock. 1:47.83, wow. 36.64, the last 600. And Last of the Line stamps himself here today with a quality performance. Needless to say, Trap for Fools dropped out. Cockney Crew was entitled to give it away. It was gasping at the 400, and Last of the Line swooping around them there, and they have sprinted well clear of the remainder. The winner raced by L. Rogers, T. Sanders, R. Wilson, Dr. J. Moran, J. White, K. Gould, Stephen Miller, A. B. Rogers, by Blackfriars from Catch the Cat. It's win 6 out of 9. Ryan Hill aboard, his regular rider for trainer Stephen Miller. Montalina by Rubik from Corora Blue. Darren McAuliffe and Chris Parnham is second home. And third is number 15, Paddy's Shadow by Dane Shadow from Paddy Milas. Sean O'Donnell, the rider for trainer Raquel Williams. The last event today, Avalon Bay number 3 is out. Let's go to Brittany joining us in the yard. And that was some kind of detonator stakes. The time, it's breathtaking, 1:47.83. And he's had to come from back around them. Surging clear. What's next here for Last of the Line?
What a performance that was to win the detonator. SJ joins me now. You've said all along that this horse has a nice race in him, and that the better quality he opposed, the better horse we would see. And I think that's what we saw today.
Yeah, I think so, Britt. You know, he's a pretty good horse. Yeah, he's mind-boggling.
What do you do with him next? Obviously, there is a situation where he will get points. What's the plan going forward?
Look, I was sort of toying with the idea of taking him to Bunbury for the Cup. Now he's won this race, I'm liable to turn him out and give him a spell or you know, I'll have a think about things. But he has got a good race in him.
We can definitely see that. When you compare him to the early stages of his career to where he is now, how do you compare him?
Look, you know, he's a work in progress. He's still learning. I think today, you know, I seen him at the 800 metres and I thought, you know, I didn't really want you to be going that well, but it's the first time he went too early. Ryan went too early, but he was going too well. And the day he gets the right run race and he can just sit off and wait till the turn, he'll blow a good field away.
I think he will. He's very, very exciting. Good luck going forward and congratulations on today.
Yeah, thanks very much.
There's SJ Miller. His team is firing. This horse in particular, he's always had so much presence about him and they've said all along just how much improvement there is when he has something to chase. And we really saw him elevate today. Scott, coming into the corner, he was absolutely travelling.
He certainly was. He was in that three wide train that you could see was building as those leaders, Cockney Crew, Trap for Fools, were starting to feel the pinch of that overall race time, 147.83. We don't see 1800s run that quick here at Ascot Britain. You could just see, as SJ Miller said, he was travelling so well at around the 600 to 800 metre marker that Ryan Hill really had no choice but to get him into the clear air and down the outside. They've skipped right away from the rest of the field. 147.83, Hilly. Now, you would have watched a lot of racing over the years. We've seen it here at Ascot. We haven't seen them go that quick for a while. What was it like out there?
Yeah, they went quick, but he was jogging in the run. Absolutely. He's a really nice horse. I've said all along he's going to be better ridden like that. And just because we keep drawing them gates, it's hard when you're on $1.70 pop not to just lob the box seat. He's been getting the job done. The other day, they said it was a good four. It was chopped out, you know, and I said to the owners after, don't worry, he just got complete. He's lost here, you know, like going to the gate. So he was going to be lost on that track down there. So he come back here today, I was real confident. Like all I want to do, SJ, good as always, just ride your own race. I just wanted to follow Chris everywhere. Going too good. I just had to pop off his back sooner than I wanted, but big horse, didn't want to lose momentum, and he just jogged up and done what he done.
Now, remembering that you are on a media ban, so you can't say too much, Hilly, if you were thinking about choosing a race, Bunbury Cup, Bunbury Stakes, which way would you feel that would be best for him?
I'll leave that completely up to SJ because he leaves the riding up to me. So, but I think whichever way he goes, he'll be competitive. But just keep riding him like that because his turn of foot is just, you know, like same again today. He hit the front, let down good, and then he just wandered around. Just does what he does. It's exciting to ride.
What kind of horse would he be if he had a set of shades on?
Yeah, that was the, at the sales we were talking because, as you know, SJ and Vernon are best friends. They're side by side all week. And he said, oh, we either go the stakes and the shades or we go to this race. And he didn't want to go the shades yet. It's just looking after him because, you know, he said he's going to be better than Archie, which is Variation, which is, that's a big call because Variation was a good horse for him. So he said, to be fair, SJ said all along, this will be the next one. And he's been right so far.
I think Variation might have run fourth in a Railway Stakes. Is Last of the Line eventually going to head that way, would you imagine? Could he be a Group 1 horse?
Well, I give SJ a lot of credit, but that was probably the poorest place that he could have put him, so he's going to get a lot of points for that. So, look, that's all he's going to have to go for now, the better races. But the boys have had a great run. They're the great bunch of people. We go for dinner, have a laugh, and they just, yeah, they enjoy the thrill of it. So it's no better owners to ride for.
Congratulations, Hilly. Well done.
Thank you.
Very well said. I love hearing them talk about this horse. They speak about him with such fondness. Ryan Hill, SJ Miller, combined with Last of the Line, taking out the Detonator.